The success story goes on. Liverpool's remarkable consistency continues to flourish. 12 months ago, Bob Paisley led this parade of honour, but this year it's Joe Fagan receiving all the accolades at the end of his first season as manager. But typically, he prefers others to receive the bulk of the praise. Most notably, skipper Graeme Souness.
Start off in August, I'm hoping to end up like this, and, you know, it's happened. Hopefully we're doing the same this time next year.
Does it seem, still seem the same to you as it all the previous occasions?
It's better now out than it was the first time. I mean,
really?
It's not that, yeah, it's not a cliche, that's a fact. The older you get, you think you're going to miss it, you see. You always wonder if it's going to happen again. It will happen again.
The precedents really know no bounds. An unfamiliar trophy for such a familiar Anfield occasion, donated by the league's new sponsors, Canon UK. Another first for Liverpool. Well, the crowd not only acknowledging the league championship, but a season in which Liverpool won the Milk Cup for the fourth successive time. And if that wasn't enough, they've got the Footballer of the Year, Ian Rush, and the European Cup final to come. And how nice to see a pitch free of invading fans, allowing everyone to enjoy the celebrations without interruption. In fact, the only spoil sports on the night were Norwich City. Surely Devine's goal early in the first half wasn't in the original script. But the party was far from over. Kennedy's cross for Ian Rush to find the net for the 47th time this season. Disappointingly, there were no more goals. The match really failing to live up to the occasion. Back in the dressing room, there was champagne, but nothing too bubbly about the atmosphere. After all, it's nothing new to Liverpool. For Phil Neal, though, it's a bit more personal. A record equaling 7 championship medals. Well, most of the players were already thinking of that European Cup final in Rome in 2 weeks. Just time, though, to satisfy some 2,000 Kopites who refused to leave the ground without a last glimpse of the new trophy.